All right, guys, getting started right now.
That's right, Mark Telly.
First stop of the MZWST Tour. We're going to get this first match going right now between Santos Sambajon and Ernesto Dominguez. And this is Daniel with POVPOOL, and I'm sitting here with Box. And we're going to sweat this first match, which is going to be an even race to nine between the two players. This is day two of the first stop of the MZWST Tour. Be sure to check out MZWST8Tour.com to find out how you can get involved with this tour of 12 dates happening between now, August 9th and 10th, to March 2015, 12 stops in all. Pretty exciting, huh, Box?
Oh, yeah, I've been having a blast, man. I'm really excited about these cats from West State, man. Their contribution to this game, they got me for life. In the meantime, we ought to wrap this up with Santos. I'm practicing on this on table one, and they're going to rack them, and let's go. I'm anxious to see what's going to happen here. My partner, Santos, you know I call him the Little Warrior, and adversary, Mr. Dominguez. You guys already know how I feel about Mr. Dominguez. Knows all the moves, knows all the tricks. You can be a gentleman and play this game. He's a perfect person for that. I guess Santos chooses to practice a little more. And Mr. Dominguez just sitting there waiting for whatever's going to go down.
Yeah, we have a final. Well, we wanted to be down to the final 16, but it's actually 17 players that we have because there's one match that went unplayed yesterday.
Not many people here today. On table six, you got the lag. Foch and Geronimo.
Yep.
Santos is kind of trying to play tricks, I guess, now with Mr. Dominguez. And Mr. Dominguez reminds me of Dave Himmel. He just sits in a chair and just don't say nothing. Just wait.
Just wait.
It's your table right now, but when it's his table, he's going to let you know.
Mauro Paez is warming up on table 10. Reed Fleming is getting ready to play Brian Law, who is so far MIA. We're waiting on him, and that is the one match from the one loss side that didn't play out yesterday. So Mauro won't even get to play until that match is over. Art Garcia and Steve Chaplin are starting right now on table 7. Tang Ho and Ramon Mystica are on table 2. That's Tang right there breaking.
Sounds like to me you've been learning a little something sitting in the box with Box.
Oh, well, you know, we've been doing this. You're taking my material, man. I've been updating other tables for a couple years now, Box. All right, there's the toss now. Box and Dan going to cover the action for you. That's right. POV pool and just one pocket, son.
Here we go. The turtle rack.
Yeah, that's right. The turtle rack.
I noticed on table six yesterday they had a couple issues with the turtle rack where it didn't lock the balls, a couple of the balls, and they had a little issue about that. Come to find out it was the spot on the table had nothing to do with the rack.
So far, you know, the rack's been pretty flawless, and I remember using a magic rack during an event a couple years ago, and they were brand new racks, but you know, halfway through the day they were crimping and you know they had wrinkles in them and some of them broke and stuff. These racks just seemed pretty durable.
Mm-hmm. Mr. Dominguez got the break on table one. I look to see a lot of runouts on this table with Mr. Sanderhorn and Mr. Dominguez. Both of these cats is capable of running racks upon racks. Let's see where it starts.
keep in mind, guys, this is a race to nine, even race.
Santos is trying to decide now what he's going to do. Is he going to play safe? Is he going to attempt a run out or what? Look like he might try to play safe. He's looking at that seven ball. He might try to bump that rock and get behind the seven. Yeah, that's what he did. No reward in shooting the one or trying to pocket the one. All he can do is duck and hide. Mr. Dominguez called the corner.
So that means he's this is a one rail kick. Oh, it's gonna go on the side.
That ball stays down. Mr. Dominguez loses his shot. Santos will still have an awkward shot on his deuce ball. I can't tell from where he's sitting if he can see it. But he must can see it because he's lining up for it. Looking at the three ball, see where he's going. He lined up pretty well on this three ball. He's gonna have to stop right where the three ball is to have any action on pocketing the four ball. And if he's got straight in, it's gonna be a better opportunity for him to stop and pocket the four ball. Come over for the five ball. Yeah, he should be off and running here. He should be off and running here. He got to do something with the six ball because it may not pass the seven. And I don't understand why he didn't look at that prior to the four ball shot. You got to look two shots ahead. So now he's going to do something by pulling the ball, taking a chance on the rock coming in contact with the eight ball. And not getting them positioned for the six. That's why it's so important to be a couple shots in front of yourself. He's gonna go to the side pocket with the six ball. Good shot. Executed real well. Stop the rock where the six is and pocket the seven.
Rodrigo and Foch Garcia. Game one has already gone to Rodrigo. It's 1-0. Rodrigo Geronimo against Foch Garcia right now.
All right, you guys, I'm drinking coffee, so I don't want to hear it. Trying to get my day started like the rest of you. Santos lined up on this eight ball real well. He's going to probably pull it just a hair. He put the spin to it, went three rails. That's a good shot. Bounce up and pocket the nine. Game one goes to Santos. Alternate the breaks. It is Santos' break. Mr. Dominguez breaks on odd. Santos breaks on even. I look around the room, everybody's in action. My friend Bo is playing his friend Chris back there on table four. They know each other real well. Lori is playing Chris Whittigan. They know each other real well. Tang Ho is playing Ramon, and they also know each other real well. This is a friendly game.
And technically, the only unknown that we have here today is Rodrigo.
That's correct.
Who seems to be carrying himself real well. He's taken over from the second rack after Foch missed a four ball. No, I can see if I can get him on Facebook.
Santos just broke. You might have heard the exchange between Mr. Dominguez and Daniel. They're trying to find Mr. Long. No one wants to lose by forfeit.
Okay. We are missing a player, Brian Law, who's supposed to play Reed Fleming. So if anybody knows Brian Law in the audience and knows his phone number, wants to give him a phone call, he might have overslept. So he's only got a couple of minutes to call in and let everybody know where he is. So if anybody can get a hold of Brian Law, we would really love him to make an appearance here today. But obviously, schedule permitting and rules permitting, we might not be able to give Brian the chance to play if he can't get here very, very soon.
Well, these cats at West Coast and Mass Cues, I'm pretty sure within reason, will work with it.
Yes,
they're
I
very
agree.
Fail here.
And that was the final call, which basically will mean that if he doesn't make it this morning, Reed will already be a winner by default, and he'll go on to play Mauro Paez. And Rodrigo has won his second rack against Foch Garcia. It's 2-0, Rodrigo Geronimo.
Santos seems to be moving right along. He's making good selections. This is his second rack. He just walked down and checked number ball five. He's stroking the ball real well.
Did you put this song on the jukebox? I know this is your favorite song, man.
Oh, yeah.
This is what you wake up to in the morning.
Every morning.
Every morning. All right.
I was just, while you were talking to me, I was watching Tang Ho do push-ups. I wonder if they betting push-ups or what.
side bet push-ups.
Which is not unusual, but they was doing push-ups there.
Well, I got to tell you, Ramon's not a big guy. I sure would like to see him lose a bet
and do some
to do some push-ups. That might be worth recording.
Yeah, Santos is moving right along. I noticed these guys have shirts that have collars.
Okay, so we do have Brian Law as an official forfeit for this event. So Reed Fleming and Mauro Paez are gonna commence from the final 16, folks.
Meanwhile, the little warrior is working. You know, it's nice to watch someone in 9-ball or 10-ball make selections, execute shots, and run out. And Mr. Sanderhorn seems to be at the top of that class. This is his second rack. He's getting ready to go up 2-0 on Mr. Dominguez. He seems to be in good spirits too. Mr. Dominguez rack. Sanderhorn goes up 2-0.
2-0. Race to 9.
Foch is on 6 and is at his shot. Foch is down 2-0. Fox just missed a three ball. You can't do that playing Geronimo. Not that many people in the stands. Not as humid as it was yesterday. Hard Times tournament is sectioned off from the ball banger side. Very few people on the tournament side. Mr. Dominguez is up for his break on table one. Mr. Dominguez pocketed the nine ball, the one ball, and the rock.
Yeah.
Tang Ho on table two is getting ready to break. Well, we're going to watch Santos run another rack. The layout on the table.
I'm not really seeing any problems here. I don't, you know, the five could be difficult, but I don't think he's going to have a problem.
Come off the rail a little bit here. You know, just bag up and get the five ball. He'll be all right. He has an opportunity here to go up 3-0 on Mr. Dominguez. And they're racing to 9.
Rodrigo Geronimo is pocketing a 10 ball again. He's going to be up 3-0 on Foch Garcia.
He hits the ball real crisp.
And, yeah, this young gentleman is rumored to be a world beater in the Philippines, taking down cats like Efren Reyes, Dennis Herculio, Ronnie Elcano, Warren Kiamko, Roberto Gomez, and many others out there. I've even heard him going head to head with Jeffrey Ignacio and beating him. So we look forward to catching a little bit of Rodrigo. And what just happened?
He didn't like the alignment that he got on the six ball. He can still make it. He just got to go to the right of the 10 ball, and it's affecting the way he planned to get shape on the 8. See, that's what he's upset about. If he pockets the 6 ball and stay above the 7 ball, then the rock is going to have to go all the way around the table and come back down to get to that 8 ball. And he didn't want to do that. He wanted to get straight where he could stay there.
He could cinch this ball and just...
Well, that's what he's going to do. He's going to pull the 6 ball past the 10. Like so. See, but he didn't want to be up that high.
Yeah.
Because now he's got to get to that 8 ball. That's
he's
got to
work
ball.
A little bit. Yeah, he's on the wrong side. Yeah. But he'll be all right.
He got the whip, bro. He's going to whip it.
Yeah.
He's going 3 rails. 1, 2, 3. Possibly 4 and come back. Or he going to go inside.
Or just go with 1 rail.
Inside, yeah.
Yeah, that's what he's doing.
Like so, yeah.
And now he's real straight. He's looking up to the pool gods. That's for sure.
What's with this point where the rock should have been?
What's that?
These guys, when they miss where the rock, they wanted the rock, they always point to it.
Yeah, like to where they wanted it to be.
Why you didn't point to it before? Why you point to it after this?
Yeah.
A little spice there. Well, a lot of guys.
As if it's
that.
Some trick you're showing us.
Exactly.
Right?
I wanted to be
that's
here.
That's where I wanted it.
Yeah, well, it didn't hit there.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, wow, that's amazing. Please, play on.
You want to impress me, show me before. He's going to really stroke this ball, though. He's staying high with it.
No.
What is he doing? Even the best players sometimes lose concept. And Santos is probably one of your top 10.
Well, he got a little lost in the woods, you know.
Yeah, but he's a great money player, that's for sure.
He really is.
Oh, my goodness. Not to say Mr. Dominguez is not either, but I'm just saying, Santos, he feared by many people.
He's all right. That's going to be that's gonna be 3-0. And meanwhile, it's still 3-0 on the next table over. Rodrigo Geronimo is dominating his match with Foch Garcia.
And Mr. Dominguez just sitting there, just polite, just as quiet, looking around the room at other games taking place. Not many people have that demeanor. But he has that demeanor where he can stay in the box and also look around. He's been doing it long enough. Taking other activities. But when it's his shot, somebody gonna release the hounds because he's gonna take the shot. I saw a slight movement in Santos' hands.
Just now?
Just now. I'm gonna have to pay attention to that.
Like a tremor?
I saw it before when he was playing Bobby Emmons. And I didn't comment on it at the time.
Uh-huh.
But I just now saw that. One of my favorite money players, too, but I just saw that. When I'm playing one pocket, I do that a lot. You pocket a ball and intentionally walk away from it and let your opponent put it on the spot. And you watch his hands. That tells you a lot of, that gives you a lot of information, a lot of feedback. If he's nervous, how he holds the ball, how he grips the ball, how he pockets the ball, that gives you indication.
Even the backhand mindset. Tremor too on the stroking.
You got to learn the little tricks.
4-0, Rodrigo Geronimo on Foch Garcia, 4-0.
I don't think this kid is going to shut Foch out. But it's a possibility because he's hitting the balls real well. My friend Bo Rennigan, he couldn't get it dialed in yesterday. And after the match, we were such good friends, I could speak to him. But I chose not to because I saw he was having a problem dialing it in. And I didn't think he needed any added pressures that I might have suggested or created, so I chose not to speak to him. I hope he didn't take it personal. I'll talk to him about it later on today. He did have a bewilderment look on his face. I didn't know if it was because I didn't speak or say nothing to him and he was expecting me to, or just because of the way he lost the match. So I chose to just ignore it and keep pushing. Looks like young Chris, if he wins the match he has with Bo, young Chris gonna finish in the money. Well, in fact, they are playing the same.
Actually, everybody's in the money today.
Everybody's
in the money. Everybody's at least $125 in their $65 entry fee.
Well, I'm sure his mom would love that because she had a little help with some gas.
You know, she's already told me that she hasn't told Chris yet, and I'm just gonna go ahead and tell the audience that if he does well in this, she will go ahead and take him up to San Francisco for the next event, Sacramento for the August 23rd, 24th event.
I'm not surprised to hear that because I could see as I introduced myself to her yesterday, I didn't know who she was and I was just speaking to her. She is actually into this. I can see her getting a little deeper involved in this.
Yeah, you know.
Very nice lady.
And you know, it seems like Chris is reciprocating. He's improving his game. He's doing what he needs to do to work on it. And, you know, I would imagine his school is fine because usually no parent would want their son or daughter...
Stipulated.
Yeah, going out and competing like this in a sport unless their grades were all right.
Mr. Dominguez won the last game. It is now 3-1. Mr. Dominguez's break. Geronimo's getting ready to go 5 up on Foch. one of your better players here at Hard Times.
Boy, he's cueing the ball real well with Rodrigo.
And he's doing it with authority. Just went up 5-0 on Foch. Now that I'm speaking about her, I didn't see her. She must be on the other side. Or she's down at the bar. Oh, I see her. Chris' mother's down there by the game, watching Chris. A couple people around her down there, too, watching that game. Ooh, Santos just made a heck of a bank.
And got great shape.
And the table's wide open. I look to see him go up 4-1. Anticipating that. Foch has a funny look on his face. Foch is not hitting the balls hard either.
He's not getting the break. No.
Well, it's not so much the break. It's just he doesn't.
Santos just told somebody to be quiet. Talking to Nestor.
Santos could probably hear him.
Yeah, because you know sometimes when your friend is talking in the room, you can hear your friend because it's distinct to you.
Well, you know what? The higher ups here, and when I say the higher ups, the Filipino regiment here has a pecking order, and that pecking order is designed behind who is the top dog and who's not all the way down. Santos is one of the top dogs, so when he speaks, whoever he's speaking to listens. A couple of young guns is taking into action too. One of my favorites, Dark Mark, Filipino Dark Mark. Very well schooled in the game of billiards. Santos is beamed in. You can tell by the look on his face, his demeanor at the table. He's beamed in. And as I look out over the billiard room, all these cats with shirts that have collars on.
It's a little cooler in here today, too, than it was yesterday.
Yeah, well, they got these polos, thin polos on, and everybody has a collar. It looks civilized. Why do you
rock? Trying to get some scores. Santos right now is on the 50-yard line. He got caught behind the 9 ball. And he doesn't want to mess around and lose this game. You know, he's up 3-1. It's a nice, healthy lead. To let Ernesto back in right now could really be dangerous for him.
Well, he's going to have to go behind the 8 ball. And he's going to have to put that rock at an angle on that 8 ball so that he cannot take advantage of the combination. It's going to take precision play for this. And I can't judge if he can even see the 8 ball, but he's going to have to get behind it in such a way that he cannot use it as a combination for the 9 ball. See, I can't see the distance between the rock in the rail, the 9 in the rail, or the 8 in the rail. And Santos is looking at it real good now.
Ernesto's just biding his time because he knows he's gonna be up next.
It's a good thing about these guys, especially when you know them really well, and watch their demeanor when they're thinking and see what the outcome of it and how they execute the shot. Oscar himself is looking at this shot. Just like I said.
No rail. You know what? He had a good plan for that ball, but he started dabbling with the percentages, man. And
yeah, well, see, now's the time not to get down on yourself either. You know, it's got a long way to go.
Yeah.
3-2. He's got a very long way to go. Mr. Dominguez break. Mr. Dominguez breaks on even. Santos breaks on odd. Or do I have it backwards? Santos breaks on odd. Mr. Dominguez breaks on even. Which one? It's 5 games up, 6 games. Santos breaks on even.
Rodrigo takes 6 games on Foch.
Mr. Dominguez just reminds Santos, break the balls. All that old practicing, hey, that's over with. You in the pit, let's go. Which is the proper attitude to have. You cannot let Santos dictate the tempo of the game.
What are you saying? What was he doing?
He was actually practicing the shooting the ball around the table like he was going to check and see if the table was level. And I heard Mr. Dominguez tell him, break.
Yeah.
In other words, let's go.
Yeah.
And that's a little bit. Look at his hands. See his hands? Look at his hands.
Interesting.
Mr. Dominguez might sense that too. I'm pretty sure we'll see more related to that. I'm not going to continue to point it out, but I want to see Mr. Dominguez's attitude towards it when he realizes it. So far, we've had 5 games, just the beginning of the 6th game, and no one's pocketed the 10 ball on the break or in combination to win the rack.
You can't win with the 10 ball on the break.
I understand.
Yep.
It has to come back, I understand. Yep. But I haven't seen it being pocketed, and nor have I seen a combination pocketing the 10 ball to win the rack.
I haven't seen, I don't think I've seen one of those. I have seen a 10 ball break, but yeah. Not
a combination to win, no.
And I've only seen about 2 or 3 break and runs this whole event.
Correct. Well, I saw Santos just do 1.
Yeah, that was this one today, this morning.
Right. I'm anxious to see how Lori does back there. You know, Lori's an old Lion himself, and he's just now coming back into the world of billiards. And Lori's an adversary feared by many in this room too. He's playing Chris Whittigan on table 3. I like to see where he stands, or when the standings, the smoke clears, where he stands. Foch is down 6-1, 6-0 on table 6. What an opportunity to go 6-1. There you go, Foch. Don't go for the shutout. Don't let him shut you out.
Well, we just seen a terrible shot by
Santos.
By Santos. He tried to play safe on the 1, came around 2 rails and scratched in the side. So Ernesto's going to get a chance to tie this up. Not an easy rack, though, by any means. A little bit of work, but the 310.
He just called
it. The 310 could be on. Oh, he called it 110?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, there you go. There's your combo.
As I spoke. I don't, the only thing I can say right now is, as I look out over this room, I would have loved to see more West State patches on the players' shoulders. I also would like to see more Mez Q patches on the players' shoulders. I guess they will improve that as the tour goes.
Well, you know, this tour was born very quickly.
I also spoke to him about it already. That's why I could say that.
Mm-hmm. Three to three.
And Oscar Dominguez is sitting on the sidelines.
Steve Chaplin is down against Art Garcia, 3-1. And I believe they're both racing to 8.
Geronimo has an opportunity to go out here and make it 7-1. If he pockets this one ball and don't come in contact with anything else, he's off and running. Mr. Dominguez is playing safe. I don't know if he left a shot for him or how it looks. I can't see from this angle. But you know, Mr. Dominguez is one of those guys that when it's not his shot, he's out the way. You ain't never had to say nothing to him. Never. Now, he comboed the 6-ball. I didn't see him calling, but I guess Mr. Dominguez is a professional. They're both professionals. Obvious things like that you don't have to call. Santos didn't get as high as he wanted on that 3-ball. This cat, Geronimo, is having his way on the round green leaf table. He's having his way on the round green leaf table. Oh, very good shot, that Geronimo shot. Tang Ho just broke again against Ramon. Santos bumped the 8-ball, but I don't think it's going to be a problem. He's taking a look at the 5-ball. Getting shape on the 5-ball. But he got to remember, he's got to get down there to the 7. And I'm just talking out loud. I'm not trying to tell Mr. Santos how to play at all. Just my perspective. Good shot. Good shot. A little angle on the 7. He can come up and get the 8-ball side pocket. Geronimo on table 6 is having his way. He got kind of close on that 6-ball on the bottom rail down there. So he's going to play a defensive shot on table 6 against Foch. Santos has got real good control on this rock. Geronimo got right on top of the 10-ball on Brunswick Boulevard. He doesn't have a straight-in shot. He just called a pop. He's shooting. He called the side pocket. Santos. Pocketing a 10-ball. It is now 4-3. Santos. Santos break. Bonch has an opportunity to pocket the 10 ball. Not a good shot, but an opportunity. He came in contact with it and moved, but he just gave it away. And I'm glad to see he did not concede the game. Let the man pocket the ball. I like that. Soft one I would like. 4x8. Santos break. Table one. He just scratched. Geronimo's up 7-1 on the green leaf table. Foch Garcia unable to get it started. Mr. Dominguez is up. Ball in hand. More people are starting to come in now. Foch is a little warm right now. Probably a little hot, a little sticky. Can't seem to get it started. The firepower that Geronimo have, unbelievable. Can't wait to see this kid on the stream again.
Yeah, he's playing a winner's game right now. I wouldn't, not to take down anybody else's game here, but he's definitely playing the final match kind of game right now, so I would definitely definitely one of my picks to make it to the top four players.
I'm gonna take an underdog. I'm gonna go with an underdog. I think I'll take Little Chris top four.
Little Chris? Yeah, well, hey.
Yeah. That's not taking anything from anybody else.
No.
I've got a lot of factors in there. Bad games, may have a bad game, the whole nine yards. But I'll take Little Chris. And he is representing West State Billiards. He has the shirt on, logo on. Mm-hmm. He's in full dress, full attire. He just made a bad...
Santos missed.
He just made a bad... shot there. So did Little Chris back on table four.
I heard that. I heard that shot.
Santos is getting down on himself now. Mr. Dominguez might use that against him and advance himself into the next round.
Rodrigo just played an amazing, very good bank on this three ball. Cross banked it like a one pocket player.
As he plays, you can tell he has a lot of billiard knowledge. Mm-hmm. He's using the system real well. Stays down and follows through real well. Very talented young man. Yeah, Foch ready to go down 8-1. Foch is a gentleman, and Foch will not let him pocket the last ball in the last game. He will concede the game, I believe. Out of respect. He just conceded the game. Hey, he will not let that man pocket the ball. Good sportsmanship.
8-1, Rodrigo against Foch.
Foch is not a quitter. It's just respect. And you know me, I believe in pocketing the last ball, but under certain conditions, you must show the respect to your opponent as he is to show it to you. And small things you can't let get in the way of that. Fox's break on table six. He didn't even wait, he just ran into him. Let the kid run out, let him and then concede the game. We'll see more of Mr. Foch. Mr. Dominguez broken, scratched. Foch has a shot, but it's not much of a shot. He's probably not going to really try to pocket the ball. He realizes everybody's here to see that kid shoot. So he's going to let the kid shoot and endure more pain. But he's a big boy. He can take it. He done dished it out many times. He can take it. There are more people coming into the stands now. Santos is picking his way through this rack. Geronimo is picking his way through his rack. Santos made a boo-boo, came in contact with a 10 ball.
He hooked himself real bad though too. I don't know how easy it is to hit this ball.
He's going to go down and come back up.
He might have to do it two rails.
Geronimo's on ball four. And everyone seems to be impressed with his talent, as I am. Santos hasn't figured out what he's going to do yet on table two, on table one. Oh yeah, his cat's gone. Six ball side pocket back up, seven ball, eight ball. And by the time he gets to the eight ball, I expect Foch to concede the game out of respect. Can you believe this kid held up a seven ball? Oh, that's even worse. That's even worse.
Oof. Stroke of luck for Ernesto.
Yeah, it was.
It's a good match right here. 4-4. Santos had a 3-0 lead, didn't he?
Foch is going to win another game. He's getting ready to go 8-2. Foch, don't get so angry. He started hitting balls with too much force. He's angry at himself. It's not even his break. Oh, how embarrassing would it be if this kid broke and ran out? Mr. Dominguez is going to win this rack. Not too many high dollar cues I can see. I see an old McDermott, a couple Predators. Oh, I haven't seen it all day and Geronimo just hit it. Broke and made a 10 ball on the break. Great to see. He has a shot on the one, but not a guaranteed pocket. You have to be a little creative there. But he has enough stroke to do it. He gave it to Fox real, real subtle. Mr. Ming is 5, Santos 4. Santos rack, he's taking his time. Fox made a good attempt, he came in contact with the one ball. Geronimo just called a one ball side pocket. Santos racking his balls on table one.
Yeah, he is shaking a little bit. He's moving. His hands are moving. But you know, I have a tremor in my backhand now. It's been about a year and a half. And it goes away after about 2 hours of play, an hour and a half of play. I start to relax.
You have to decipher the tremor.
Yeah, is it nerves or is it age?
No, me, I have one too. But I have one too, but mine is for the adrenaline. When my adrenaline gets up, I tremor a little bit. But I seen it with a Bobby Evans too, Santos. Table 6. This kid is trying to figure out what he's going to do with this 5 ball. It's tied up with the 8 ball. Santos trying to find a way that 3 ball is going to go. He's a monster. This kid here is a monster.
Oh, yeah.
You had to know your three. You had to know your diamond system to do what he just did. And he knew exactly what he was doing. He's calling the 9 ball, which was his shot before he shot it. Excuse me.
Called
the 8 ball. Santos is trying to fight his way back. He's down 5-4, race to 9. This is a 9-9 rating. He played safe. He played safe. I like that shirt that Fox has on. It's like a crepe. It's really, 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 really transparent. Keeps you cool. He's trying to make up his mind whether he's going to shoot the 5 ball. He wanted to leave the 5 ball on the bottom rail. He missed it. Santos trying to pocket the 3 ball. Geronimo missed the side pocket. A rare miss for him. And he just laughed to himself. As he looks up at the P's, he sees he's in front 8-2. Fox is going to win this game. Fox is going to win this game. It's getting ready to be 8-3. The game with Santos, he's going to pocket this 5 ball, but he's trying to figure out where the 3 ball is going to go. six ball, excuse me, is going to go. Foch wins. 8-3. Foch is trying to battle back. One game at a time. You can't win the match. You're going to win one game at a time. Mr. Sanderhorn is doing his thing on table one. Ramon and Tang Ho, they're awful quiet back there. Gloria and Chris Whitaker. Bo is up again. This is the third time I looked up and saw Bo standing at the table. I think Bo just broke him. That's a strong break. Foch just broke on table six. Santos missed on table one. That's Mr. Dominguez shot. And he is going to run out. It will be 6-4. On table six. Foch got to go to the rail first. He scratched. That was a dagger. Foch scratched. That's a dagger. What a dagger. Geronimo was looking at the table, selecting the pattern that he's going to play, looking at four ball and nine balls tied up. He's trying to figure a way to pocket the four ball. Looks like the four ball is going to go to the corner pocket or one of the other sides. It just depends on how he decides to play it. Mr. Dominguez is racking. He's in front of Mr. Sandoval. 6-4. Geronimo looks like he's going to play safe. I don't understand why. Oh, okay. He laid down a heck of a save. A monster shot. Ooh, did he put a monster lick down.
That has three foul written all over it.
Oh, no. He going to get ball in hand. That's it.
Well, no. Look where the three and the eight is. I mean, you know.
But once the deuce ball or the one ball comes in contact with the eight, the three ball going to fall. Straight in combination. There it is, it's over.
Four.
Yeah, the four and the nine is straight in.
Yeah. Ernesto now is taking the lead on
Sandoval.
Santos, it's now 6-4. Santos had a 3-0 lead in this match. That's all in the past now.
He chose to walk away. He didn't say nothing either, Mr. Dominguez. He just walked away. So Mr. Dominguez takes his opportunity to walk around and seize the moment, wipe his hands clean, take a break, move around, see what he's going to do. Mr. Dominguez also decided to walk away. We're going to swing over to camera three, let you see the end of this game on table six between Geronimo and Foch Garcia. He just called a combination. nine ball, four ball to the nine corner pocket. I think he might have went too far here. I don't know if that five ball passes the seven. It must do because he's beaming in on it. It's now going to
nice shot, good recovery.
Oh yeah, Rodrigo's doing his thing. It's over. Flatch is not gonna let him pocket the 10 ball.
No. He's gonna get perfect shape too.
I can't believe it, Flatch is letting him shoot.
Wow.
Fox didn't do too well against that one. That kid shoots real well. Of course, Ernesto now, who's a Filipino himself, he had to go over and speak to the kid like he's telling him something secret to do.
Oh, Nestor?
Yeah, Nestor. Mr. Whip. Fox is in a heat right now, and I do mean that. He's really hot. It is hot in this room.
Did he just call on the one in the corner? I think he did. That's a good kick.
Well, we got table one in action. Santos, he's in a bad way, son. Mr. Dominguez got him up against the wall and he's leaking. He got a wound, but it's not deep, but he's leaking.
Yeah, that's not going to help him either.
He cut, but he not cut deep.
He's trying to stop the bleeding, but it ain't going to happen like that.
No.
He's got to be patient, you know? That's a heck of a shot he tried to play.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Life. Bread, new life. Oh, we got action in here. Table five.
Who's walking away with the rack?
No.
On two. Looks like Tang Ho.
No. It's not over.
It's not over?
No.
Okay. Yeah, because there's still a cue on the table.
Right.
That was a nice shot by Santos.
Table five is in real action. I know both of those cats.
Oh, Phil Knight?
And Al. Iranian Al.
Oh, no. Crazy Al? Oh, no.
I don't know how far this tournament intends on going. But if he gets started, somebody will have to go back there and ask him to tone it down. Because they in action for real action. They ain't down there for no $50.
No. It's probably at least $500 a set at this point.
Exactly. They had it.
You know, we might want to let them know now.
They know.
I don't know if Oscar's seen it.
I think somebody spoke to the other gentleman about it.
Table 10 is a loose game, too, some kind of action. Looks like Mark Barba playing Teve. Is that Teve over there?
If it is Teve, they're in action.
Yeah. So I guess Eddie took it upon himself to start renting those tables. To customers.
There goes Nestor. Looking like they're getting money together for something. I have no idea what it is.
Between Mark and Teve, or maybe
they're getting money together.
Maybe they're making money on Geronimo already.
No. Oh no, I see Alex from Styx snuck in on us.
Oh ho ho ho, there you go. The corporation has, the CEO has walked in.
Yeah, he's on the other side, I saw him. I believe that was him, I saw.
Yeah. Meanwhile,
back at the ranch.
Yeah, Santos is about to take his fifth game in this set, which he desperately needed. He played that good 1-6 combo, actually, Ernesto left him.
Mr. Dominguez is wiping his forehead now. He's kind of warm. I see that few more people are walking in.
I want to remind you guys that this is the Mez West State Tour, if you're just joining us. And West State Billiards is located in Fullerton, California. If you'd like to get a diamond pool table, West State Billiards in Fullerton is the authorized dealer for California. Financing available, zero down, and payments as low as $122 a month. You can order now for September delivery by calling Donnie Wessels at 714-943-7137. Call Donnie Wessels, and if you mention POV Pool this month of August 2014, you'll get a $100 discount on your purchase. That's Donnie Wessels, 714-943-7137. Order now for September, and he will hand deliver the table to you.
Because it changes the path of the game off the regular. If you move one ball after the game, it changes the outcome of the game.
Santos is disputing. What happened was he hit a ball with his cue on the break that was moving, and he's disputing that that shouldn't be a foul, but the ball is moving. You can't touch any moving balls on the table.
As far as I'm concerned, you can touch any ball on the table. But here's what happens. In events like this, when they give out flyers, all you gotta do is give out a flyer with the rules on it. That's all. All you gotta do, give out a flyer with the rules on it. It's the same amount of time to print them. You can download them off of any computer, off of any printer. And that way, it don't be no discrepancy. Right now, can you tell me what rules they're going by?
Well, they have printed the rules.
Where are they at?
They're online. They're on the Mez West State Tour website.
They're online.
And, well, no, they printed them, too. They're, you see on the counter right there? On the counter right there is the rules.
On the stream table?
On the stream table right there where they are on that counter, taped to the counter. And I can quickly consult those rules right now, the exact sheet. And see if there's anything about that.
When you come in, are they available when you walk in, or just at the tables?
I believe they are available.
I didn't see any at all. I I'm just now being aware of the ones you're talking about.
I take your point, though, you know.
When you hand them out, hand them out. What rules? I know I see the rules, but...
What rules?
APA.
They're going by, I think, UPA international rules.
No soft breaking. No pattern racking.
Okay, the following are standard fouls at 10 ball, and rule number 8 is hitting another ball during the shot, which as a result changes or crosses the path of another ball.
Only if it crosses the path of the cue ball. So you can hit a ball as long as it don't cross the path of the cue ball. Yes?
This is what it says here. Hitting another ball during the shot, which as a result changes or crosses the path of the cue ball. So that's just what I, you know.
Yeah.
And I'm not.
No. I just believe they should have them more readily available.
Yeah.
You know, you don't have to second guess. You can just pick the rules up as you come through the door.
Yeah.
And I believe we had a players meeting too.
Mm-hmm.
Rules should have been gone over there. That's what the players' meeting is for. But probably with the format and as many people that they had, there was no time for that.
I think, though, what makes it a little awkward is that it's Ernesto's son defending the rule to Santos, who's in the match with his dad. So this is what makes the rule a little bit awkward. Oh, old-timer.
My pops.
Oh, that's, yeah.
That's my partner right there.
Yeah.
My papa, as you know, the other one.
Yeah.
He coming over here to see me. I know he is.
What's up, baby?
I called you. You didn't answer.
Man, I'm curious.
I know. I called you a couple days ago.
I got to bless
you. Oh, did you? Okay.
The pool's all around me.
Aaron called last night.
Yeah. What are you talking about?
I want to know what I was doing.
It's been so hot. El Salvador took the potato chips out of the water. He gets that late till he got pulled and it jumps around.
Bacon in the house.
Hey, Bacon. They roasted me already, saying I'm talking too loud. I guess that's too, because Mr. Dominguez is on table one. Everybody's defending Mr. Dominguez. You know me, I keep it 100. Hey, what's up, Bacon? Since I've been reprimanded, I'm gonna shut up.
Looks like Steve Chaplin is down 6-2 against Art Garcia. Tang Ho, I think he's down 4-2 against Ramon Mystica. 4-3, it looks like maybe 4-3.
Mm-hmm.
Still got Chris Robinson and Bo Runningen. Lori versus Chris Wedekin. Reed Fleming and Mauro Paez are still playing. Only match that's closed is Geronimo and Foch. So Geronimo will advance on the winner's side.
Thank you. Good news, man. is to just make sure that they, when they say they got it. You know what? We can just take a picture.
Okay, sorry y'all, I had to take a little break there. Score update now, 7-6. And Ernesto needs 2 games. It looks like Santos is here to take game 14 and tie it up at 7-7. So we have another match that has concluded. Bo Runnigan has defeated Chris Robinson on the one loss side. So Chris Robinson is eliminated. He'll get 13th through 16th. And 13th through 16th place. And we'll take $125. What's that? Art Garcia is up 6-3 against Steve Chaplin. This is a wide open table for Ernesto. See any problems really, except maybe the 8 to the 9. But if he can come across the 8 at an angle, bring his cue ball out for the 9 ball, we'll have to see how he takes it on if he gets there. On the inside of the 8, but he's all right. Puts Ernesto on the hill. Thank you. Tang Ho and Ramon Mystica in a match right now. Tang's asking for a ruling on a hit. Ramon Mystica gets a good hit, and Ernesto misses the one here. Not where you want to be when you when the pressure's on, and Ernesto Santos is feeling it right now. Thank you. Santos said, give it to him. This is the break that Ernesto needed. Take advantage, but he did get a roll. Now Santos might decide to just strike the right side of the six ball as thin as he can. Try to play a safety. Steve Chaplin, you want to sit down and say hello? Joining me now is Steve Chaplin, who just finished playing Art Garcia. What was the outcome of your match? I saw that you were down for a bit.
Yeah, I lost. I lost 7-3. Just didn't play that well. Just a little bit too nervous. Just couldn't work through it.
From the one loss side.
Yeah, so I'm out. But it was a great tournament. Really well run. Had a lot of fun. Didn't play very well, so I was happy just to come into money.
That's good. That's good attitude. It's actually really nice to see you again because, you know, we don't get a lot of events where some of the people that I'm familiar with, they don't come out of the woodwork, and it's good that this event and this tour has got started, you know?
Yeah, well, the tour is nice.
Really brought out a lot of people that I haven't seen in a while.
The nice thing about the tour is that there's a schedule, and you know when the events are going to be, so you can try to plan for it. And I'm really excited. I'm going to try to plan all of them.
Wow, that's good. That's great. And you know, good for you too. You can use the opportunity to keep spreading the word about Celeris and Virtual Pool 4.
Yeah, and I know I got some guys out there probably watching the stream.
Yeah, we had John Slingblade in the chat room asking about you for, constantly asking about you.
They're probably watching, playing virtual pool and watching the stream at the same time.
You know what? Take advantage of the technology. For those who don't know, Steve Chaplin, a.k.a. Tall Steve, a.k.a. Virtual Pool Steve, invented the game Virtual Pool, and he's... I guess you invented it in 1997, right?
1995.
1995, that's right. I wrote the article, so I should remember, but it's been a while. And he's now on his fourth version, Virtual Pool 4, or VP4. And you've just recently released this as an online version, right?
Yeah, we're in public beta right now and online. And we're inviting everybody out to play. It's free to start playing. Really, you can play as much as you want for free. You can play 8-ball, 9-ball, and 6-ball on a bar table for free. And then if you join, $9.95 a year, you get everything.
All the features, all the games?
Championship pool table, 10-foot pool table.
Snooker table.
Billiards,
pub pool, billiards.
Pub pool, 28 games in total. We've got a social network. We've got online tournaments. We got a great group of guys. You get your own profile page and stats and a lot of cool stuff.
And looks like John Slingblade is already posting the link in our chat room. That's awesome.
John Slingblade is one of our tournament directors. He's been working real hard to put a lot of tournaments up.
Yeah.
Keep things rolling.
That's good. So how are you feeling about your game, and how are you feeling about the competition in the MZWST State Tour?
I'm not feeling great about my game, but, I just need to play more, and I think I'll start playing better. You know, with pool, you never know.
Yeah, it's true.
I think the saying, when you're playing bad, you don't know why, and when you're playing good, you don't know why, really applies to pool.
Yeah.
I mean, you just you got to play and get in a groove, and that's what I'm going to try to do. But no matter what, you know, I'm going to come out and enjoy playing in events.
Yeah.
And
well, for you to come in the top 16 of a field of 91 players when you're basically at home, you know, programming and trying to release an online version of the greatest, you know, most realistic pool game for video gamers, this is quite an accomplishment. So,
you know, like I said, I was happy. You know, I know I can play better, but, you know, a lot of it depends on the draw and who's in it. I would say that this field was a little weaker than I expected. Mm-hmm. It was about like what the normal first Sunday tournament would
Yeah, be. Well, we had 91 players, which is a little bigger than a first Sunday,
yeah,
only six pros and 15 semi-pros. So we had basically 70 players of amateurs and sevens, which is encouraging to people who want to get involved in this tour, too.
Yeah. Honestly, for me, I don't really care. If more champions show up, that's fine. You know, I mean, it's a great opportunity to come out and play against champions. So, I'm just glad that we have a Pro-Am tour now.
Yeah, we're gonna switch quickly over to Tang Ho's match with Ramon Mystica. Ernesto Dominguez has defeated Santos Sambajon. Santos will go to the one loss side now. Bo Runnigan is also playing on table 7, sort of practicing, getting ready for his next match. He defeated Chris Robinson. And Ramon Mystica is on the phone waiting for Tang Ho to get back from a quick break. But very quickly, Steve, just let everybody know what they can do to get virtual pool on their phones, on their droids, on their iPads and computers and desktops.
Well, if you have a mobile device, Android or iOS, just go to the App Store or the Play Store and search for Virtual Pool and you'll find us there. For the PC version, we have an offline single player, which basically has career modes, it has training videos. If you want to learn to play better pool, it's a great way to learn play better in real life. You can go to www.celeris.com, C-E-L-E-R-A-S. For the online version, I think John already posted a link in there, but you can just go click on that link and go sign up for free and get rolling. Don't worry about, you know, not being a experienced VP player. We've got very friendly people in the lobby. We've got admins in there. People will be in there to assist you and get you rolling. And, you know, come on out and have some fun.
Absolutely. Well, I'm glad that I got, you know, this quick and short opportunity to talk to you about the game because, you know, I've been a longtime supporter of your product. I mean, I really, really think it's the most realistic game for gamers, the most realistic pool game you could ever use, and I think it will actually improve your real pool game.
And it does. It's amazing. We have people tell us all the time that, you know, virtual pools made their real pool game better.
Yeah.
We have players that play. We got a guy online that's got a 147 break, you know, which is
in
pretty
snooker.
Incredible in snooker. Yeah. I'm not talking about a virtual pool. I'm talking about in real life. He's got a 147 break.
Oh, I see. Okay.
I mean, we've got some very accomplished real life players that play. And we've got guys that learned how to play virtual pool that had never played real pool and then started playing real pool and became good players.
Right. Isn't that beautiful?
It is.
Great.
So,
yeah,
you know,
and you still got there's Steve Daking lessons, the instructor from England.
Right. The single player has lessons and it'll teach you, it goes from just the basics all the way up into, you know, intermediate to advanced topics.
Mm-hmm.
And you get to watch the video and then you can try the shots out in virtual pool. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, if you want, you can go to the real pool table and try them.
Yeah. And, you know, just once, very quickly, once again, before we sign off for this match, and then I'm going to start a new file. But, you know, I just want to congratulate you for all the hard work that you've done. And I especially for the online release, which is now available on Google Play and at your App Store iPhones.
And at Apple, Celeris.com.
And Celeris.com.
VPOnline.Celeris.com.
Yeah, definitely. The online version is really the success because now you guys get to play each other in real time.
Well, that's the most fun. it really depends on what you're looking for. If you're looking to get better at real pool or virtual pool, it's worth buying a single player version. If you just want to compete, the online is great. I also want to congratulate you, POVPOOL.
Oh, thank you.
You know, I mean, this is really impressive what you got rolling here. You got a lot of new technology.
Oh, yeah, well, I got, you know, I had to put my heart into it and make some changes, make some improvements, and, you know, I just think that's great. Thank you very much.
Yeah, well, we both love pool. We're both trying to boost pool.
Yeah, yeah.
And, you know, I mean, I think it's great what you're doing.
I think collectively, I think we are all doing a great job for this sport. And as a result, I think the audiences and the players and the you know, the connoisseurs of this game are growing a little bit. So with that, we're going to start a new recording. Be sure to look out for Ramon Mystica and Tang Ho. And once again, thank you to Steve Chaplin. He's still going to hang around maybe for a little bit of this match. We'll sweat this match together, but go to Celeris.com.
This is a pretty interesting match. I can't see the score. Do you know what the score is right now?
I'm going to find out right now.